Blessed Master,
blessed is our God, always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. O heavenly King, O Comforter, the Spirit of Truth, who is everywhere present and fill us all things, treasury of blessings and giver of life, come and abide in us, cleanse us from every stain, and save our souls, O good one.
Kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Thank you.
Forsaken by the Lord, my God, depart from me. Be attentive unto my help. O Lord, my salvation. Forsaken by the Lord, my God, depart from me. Be attentive unto my help. O Lord, my salvation. O God, my God, unto thee I will lift on. My soul is lifted to thee. O often hath my flesh longed after thee in thy fairness and torment and water. So in the center of the field before thee to see thy power and thy glory. For thy mercy is better than life, but I shall praise thee. So shall I bless thee, my God, and thy name will lift up my hands. And the ground that set my soul be filled. And with such a praise shall my mouth praise thee. If I remember thee on my path, the dry man is to know thee. For thou art become my help and the shelter of my wings, will I rejoice. My soul hath faith unto thee. Thy right hand hath been equipped to help me. And as for these things that sought after my soul, they shall go down into the heavenmost parts of the earth. They shall be surrendered unto the edge of the sword. Horses and foxes shall they be. The king shall be glad and glad, and we shall be praised for the quiet. For the mouth of them is stopped to speak unjust things. After that, I'll never know me, so I'll become my helper. And the shelter that wings will I rejoice. My soul hath pleased unto thee. Thy right hand hath been fit to help me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Look now to ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Look now to ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. O Lord God of my salvation, one day I cried my life before thee, but my prayer come before thee, bow down the air of my supplication. For filled with evils is my soul, my life in the Hades hath drawn nigh. I'm found with them, every down into the pit, I've become some man without help, free among the dead, left the bodies of the slain, sleeping in the grave, whom thou rememberest no more, they are cut off from thy hand. They lay me in the lowest pit of darkness and the shadow of death, against me is thy anger made strong, and all thy ills hast thou brought upon me. Thou hast removed my friends apart from me, and they have made the abomination unto themselves. I've been delivered out, and not come forth, my eyes are growing into poverty. I have cried unto thee, O Lord, the holy and long act, stretched out my hands unto thee. Nay, for the dead will thou with wonders, which in all positions raise them up, they may give thanks unto thee. Nay, shall any grave tell of thy mercy and thy truth and thy destruction. Nay, shall thy works be known in thy darkness and thy righteousness in the land that is forgotten. But ask me unto thee, O Lord, my cry in the morning, shall my prayer come before thee. Wherefore, Lord, dost thou cast off my soul and cut thy face away from me? A poor man of mine troubles me from my youth, yea, and being exalted, I was humbled and brought to distress. Thy fury is cast upon me, and thy terrors have sorely troubled me. It came around me about like water all day long, it comes to me about the enemy. Thou hast removed it far from me, for any danger of my acquaintances, because of my misery. O Lord God of my salvation, my life. By day I cried and by night before thee. Let my prayer come before thee. Bow down there into my supplication. Bless the Lord, my soul, all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forgive not all day that he hath done for thee. Who is gracious unto all thy iniquities, who healeth all thy infirmities, who redeemeth thy life from corruption, who crowneth thee with mercy and compassion, who filleth thy desires with good things. Thy youth shall be renewed as the eagles. The Lord performeth deeds of mercy and executeth judgment for all them that are wrong. He has made his ways known unto Moses, unto the sons of Israel, things that he had proved. Compassionate and merciful is the Lord, long suffering and plenteous in mercy. Not in a day will he anger, neither in eternity will he be wroth. Not according to our iniquities have he dealt with us, neither according to our sins have he rewarded us. For according to the height of heaven from the earth, the Lord has made his mercy to prevail over them that fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our iniquities from us. Like as the Father hath compassion upon his Son, so hath the Lord hath compassion upon them that feared him. For he knoweth wherever we are made, yet remember that feared us. As for man, his days are as the grass, as the flower of the field, so shall he blossom forth. For when he is passed over it, then it shall be gone, and no longer will know his place thereof. But the mercy of the Lord is from eternity, even unto eternity upon them that feared him. And his righteousness is upon sons of sons, upon them that keep his testament, remember his commandments. The Lord in heaven hath prepared his throne, and his kingdom ruleth over all. Bless the Lord, all you his angels, fighting strength and perform his word, and hear the voice of his words. Bless the Lord, all you his hosts, his ministers that do his will. Bless the Lord, all you his works, in every place of his dominion, bless the Lord, O my soul. In every place of his dominion, bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, hear my prayer, give ear to my supplication in thy truth, hearken unto me in thy righteousness. And enter not into judgment with thy servant, for in thy sight shall no man do any Then he hath persecuted my soul, he hath humbled my life down to the earth, he hath sat me in darkness of those that have long been dead. And my spirit within me is become despondent within me, my heart is troubled. I remember the days of old, I meditated on all thy rules, I pondered the creation of thy heavens. I stretched forth my hands unto thee, my soul thirsted after thee like a waterless land. Quickly hear me, O Lord, my spirit hath fainted away. Turn not thy face away from me, lest I be like them that go down into the pit. Cause me to hear thy mercy in the morning, for thee I lift my hope. Cause me to know, O Lord, the way wherein I should walk, for to thee I lift up my soul. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord, and to thee I fled for refuge. Teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness, for thy name's sake, O Lord, shalt thou look to me. In thy righteousness shalt thou bring my soul out of affliction, and in thy mercy shalt thou utterly destroy my enemies. And thou shalt cut off all them that afflict my soul, for I am thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and enter not into the judgment with thy servants. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and enter not into the judgment with thy spirit, with thy servant. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and as we may, to the ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. O our God and our hope, glory to thee.
In peace let us pray to the Lord. From above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and for those who with faith, reverence, and the fear of God entered therein, let us pray to the Lord. For our Father and Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priest of the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord. Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord. For the President of the United States, for all civil authorities and for armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Joshua, Ronnie, Adam, Andrew, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Connor, and Skyler, let us pray to the Lord. For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those in a persecution for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Glory unto thee, our due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
God is the Lord.
save us, have mercy upon us. Keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance are all holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious, be there, help us never, Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto you, Christ our God.
Hear me, O Lord.
Thine is the majesty, and thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Angel within the sepulchre cries.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Holy art thou, O God, who rest in the saints, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord.
Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord.
For his God the saints praise in the proclamation of his power.
Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord.
That we may be accounted worthy to hear the holy gospel, let us pray to the Lord God.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, stand upright, let us hear the holy gospel.
Peace be to all,
and to thy spirit.
A reading from the holy gospel according to St.
Be attentive.
At that time, Peter rose and ran to the tomb, stooping and looking in. He saw the linen cloths by themselves, and he departed, wondering at what had happened. That very day, two of them were going to a village named Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem, and talking with each other about all these things that had happened. And while they were talking and discussing together, Jesus himself drew near and went with them. But their eyes were kept from recognizing him. And he said to them, "What is this conversation which you are holding with each other as you walk and are sad?" Then one of them, named Barnabas, answered him, "Are you only a stranger in Jerusalem, and do not know the things that have happened there these days?" And he said to them, "What things?" And they said to him, "Concerning Jesus of Nazareth, who was a prophet, mighty in deed and word before God and all the people, and how our chief priests and rulers delivered him up to be condemned to death and crucified him. But we had hoped that he was the one to redeem Israel. And besides all this, it is now the third day since this happened. Moreover, some women of our company amazed us. They were at the tomb early in the morning and did not find his body. And they came back saying that they had even seen a vision of angels who said that he was alive. Some of those who were with us went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said, but him they did not see. And Jesus said to them, O foolish men, and slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken, was it not necessary that the Christ should suffer these things and enter into his glory? And beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them in all the scriptures the things concerning himself. So they drew near to the village to which they were going. Jesus appeared to be going further, but they constrained him, saying, Stay with us, for it is now toward evening, and the day is now far spent. So he went in to stay with them. When he was at table with them, he took the bread, and blessed, and broke it, and gave it to them. And their eyes were open, and they recognized him, and he vanished out of their sight. They said to each other, Did not our hearts burn within us while he talked to us on the road, while he opened to us the scriptures? And they rose at that same hour and returned to Jerusalem. And they found the 11 gathered together and those who were with them. And they said, The Lord is risen and has appeared to Simon. Then they told what had happened on the road and how he was known to them in the breaking of the bread.
Let us sing his resurrection, for that he endured the cross for us.
cleanse the multitude of my compassion, blot out my transgression, wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my iniquity, my sin is ever before me, against thee only thou sinnest and this evil before thee, that thou mightest be justified in thy words unto thou and thou art just. Behold, thou hast conceived and hast conceived, and since thou hast not carried me, behold, thou hast not carried the hidden secret things that thou hast done. Hast thou made manifest unto me, thou shalt sprinkle me with this, and I shall be faithful to thee. Thou shalt wash me, and I shall be made white as the snow. Thou shalt make me to be from my brothers, and thou shalt be humble, and they shall be close. Turn thy face away from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Create me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from my brothers, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Refresh me, destroy with thy salvation, with thy governing spirit, which thou shalt keep. I shall keep the transgressions of thy ways, and God shall keep the covenant of thy peace. Deliver me from my brokenness, O God. Thou God of my salvation, and then shall destroy from my righteousness. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips and my mouth shall declare thy praise. For if thou hadst desired sacrifice, I give me. With all burnt offerings thou shalt not be pleased. The sacrifice of the goddess, broken spirit, heart that is broken and humble, God will not despise. To show the Lord and the despise of the Son, and let the walls of the goods to be built up, and shall be pleased with sacrifice of righteousness, with oblation and all burnt offerings. And shall they offer blows upon thine altar.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Hear the intercessions of the apostles, O thou who art merciful. Blot out the multitude of our transgressions.
Thy world with mercy and compassion, exalt the horn of Orthodox Christians, send down upon us thy rich mercies. Through the intercessions of our All Immaculate Lady Theotokos and Ever Virgin Mary, whose wonder working icons and real tree we commemorate today, by the might of the precious and life giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplications of thy honorable, glorious prophet, foreign Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, all laudable apostles Peter and Paul, and of all thy holy apostles, of our fathers among the saints, great hierarchs and ecumenical teachers, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasios, Cyril, and John, the merciful patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra, Spearmen of Prometheus, Nectarius and Pentapolis, the wonder workers, of our fathers among the saints, Tikhon, Patriarch of Moscow, Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the trophy bearer, Demetrius the merce streamer, Theodore the soldier, Theodore the general, and Venus the wonder worker, of the higher martyrs, Ignatius the god bearer of Antioch, Arlampos, Eleutherios, of the holy, glorious, great women martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kiriaki, Fotini, Marina, Peresca, Brennerine, of the holy, glorious, right, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers who shone in the ascetic life, St. Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the glorious, holy, glorious, right, victorious, proto-martyr Thecla, equal to the apostles, the venerable Cilion of Athos, the new martyr Ahmed, the venerable Nicander of Pliskova, of all the saints of Alaska whose memory we celebrate today, and of all thy saints, we He beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of us sinners, and make our supplications unto thee. Have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Yada, moram, yada, moram, yada, moram. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Gospel for me, Lord, gospel for me, Lord, gospel for me.
The prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and save us.
Praises and are joined together in spiritual comfort. have authority upon the throne of the Godhead. Jesus, the Most High God, came with mighty hand and saved those who cried out unto him. Glory to thy power, O Christ.
All creation was amazed at the divine glory, for thou, O wedded virgin, didst open in thee the God of all, and its very eternal Son, who rewards the salvation of who him by praises.
As we their God be minded, celebrate this evening in the wonderful feast of the Mother of God. Come, let us clap our hands together and glorify the God whom she bore.
Love God-minded children, worship not the creature, rather than the Creator. By trampling upon the threat of fire and manly passion, they rejoice and say, oh, praise Lord and God of our fathers, blessed art thou.
We praise, we bless, and we worship the Lord, that we all be children in the first great child of the fabled of Jose. Then was the time now as his fulfillment, and the whole world is
Theotokos, and the Mother of the Light, let us honor and magnify in song.
Thank you.
mercy upon us and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All anger, remember, and sorrow, Holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theos, O Grossly Ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
O'er all the powers of heaven, praise thee, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Thank you.
with the psaltery and harp. O death, the first of strugglers, thou didst take Jesus our God as a bridegroom in the heavens. He lives to lead thy earthly bridegroom and betrothed. For the sake of thine intelligence, thou didst not succumb to thy brother's infidelities. Thou didst follow Paul, carrying the sign of the cross on thy shoulders. Thou wast not afraid of fire. The fierceness of the beast thou didst change to gentleness. Thou didst kill the seals by thy immersion in holy baptism in Christ. Therefore thou dost shine in the great struggle. Thou dost still entreat the Lord fervently for the sake of those who keep thy memory in faith forever.
Thank you.
Master.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen. In peace let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. Of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for those with faith, reverence, and the fear of God enter therein, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President of the United States, for all civil authorities, and for armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Joshua, Ronnie, Adam, Benjamin, Andrew, Thaddeus, Skylar, and Connor, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those under persecution for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. Calling to remembrance our all holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Thine is the majesty and thine is the kingdom.
save us, have mercy upon us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in remembrance, our all holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious, the gifts of this ever Mary. All the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
For thou art a good God and lovest mankind, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Thank you.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For holy art thou, our God, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever.
And unto ages of ages.
Thank you.
saints, bless God in the congregation.
Praise God.
The reading is from St. Paul's second letter to Timothy.
Let us attend.
Timothy, my son, you had observed my teaching, my conduct, and my aim in life, my faith, my patience, my love, my steadfastness, my persecutions, my sufferings, what befell me at Antioch, at Iconium, and at Lystra, what persecutions I endured, yet from them all the Lord rescued me. Indeed, all those who desire to live a godly life in Christ Jesus will be persecuted, while evil men and impostors will go on from bad to worse, deceivers and deceived. But as for you, continue in what you have learned and have firmly believed, knowing that from whom you learned it and how from childhood you have been acquainted with the sacred writings, which are able to instruct you for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus.
Peace be to thee that readeth.
And to thy spirit.
Simon's, Jesus asked him to put out a little from the land, and he sat down and taught the people from the boat. And when Jesus had finished speaking, he said to Simon, put out into the deep and let down your nets for a catch. And Simon answered, Master, we toiled all night and took nothing, but at your word I will let down the nets. And when they had done this, they enclosed a great shoal of fish. And as their nets were breaking, they beckoned to their partners in the other boat to come and help them. And they came and filled both the boats, so that they began to sink. But when Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, Depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord. For he was astonished, and all that were with him, and the catch of fish, which they had taken, and so also were James and John, the sons of Zebedee, who were partners with Simon. And Jesus said to Simon, Do not be afraid, henceforth you will be catching men. And when they had brought their boats to the land, they left everything and followed him.
Shore, so he could be seen and heard by the people who were gathered along the shoreline.
And there, from that position, he taught them. And afterward, we're told that he instructed Peter to set out into the deep and put down the nets for a catch. Now, we're not told what Jesus taught that day when he preached to the multitudes, but it must have been pretty impressive for Peter to not argue. He complied, you know, he offered the briefest little protest, but I think, he complied with the kind of an odd instruction. It's like, Lord, I do this for a living, you know, this isn't a hobby. We haven't caught anything, there's nothing out there. No, he just, okay, at your word, I shall let down the nets, he says. So I can't imagine, first of all, that he would have done that had not Jesus already made a big impression on him. And they had probably, in all honesty, had heard of Jesus by that point anyway. It wasn't like he was a complete stranger that just showed up and started teaching. They knew a little bit about him, they knew his reputation, and when they heard his teaching, that was confirmed. So, you know, Peter pretty much did what he was told. And of course we know that because of that, they caught a record number of fish. So we might back up for a moment and ask a question. It's actually a question that I don't normally recommend that we ever ask. That question is, why? You know, why is not a good question, really. There's all kinds of questions that you can ask God, but why really shouldn't be one of them. And, you know, I mean, you think about it. Why, God, have you done this to me? Why must I go through this? Why, you know, why is this happening to my life? All these kinds of things. You know, it might be natural for us to ask that, but it's not a good question because it does not come from faith. It comes ultimately from questioning the wisdom of God, the goodness of God, His care for us. You know, it's such questions assume, I suppose, that things would be different. If God were truly good, if God were really wise and loved us, you know. So we say, why, God? You're supposed to be good. You're supposed to be love. You're supposed to be mercy. Why does this happen? And that is not a proper question. Because even if God told us why, we probably wouldn't understand the answer. But it's, you know, faith rests in trust in God and believes in God and believes that all things happen. I don't really say everything happens for a reason, but I do say that God gives reason to everything that happens. Nevertheless, let's ask in this case, why? And the why were the fishermen cleaning their nets? I'm going to go through a whole list of whys here. After all, we know that they caught nothing, so there's really nothing to clean, right? But the answer could be that fishing nets catch all kinds of things besides fish, sticks, rubbish, seagulls, beer cans, you know, whatever. The nets would have to be cleaned and repaired after a nice use to make them ready to be filled with fish, hopefully, when luck returned. Well, in a sense, this speaks of our souls, which also tend to pick up all kinds of junk besides the good things that they were designed to hold. Bad thoughts, judgments, porn, fantasies, political animosities. You know, I just really feel so moved when people in church fight and argue over politics. I feel so moved. I wish I could vote. It's a terrible thing. And you know this happens when people really get into a subject. It doesn't have to be politics, it doesn't matter what side. But people just, all of a sudden, it's like everybody else is an adversary. These are crummy things that we allow our souls to snare and take in. And they really need to be cleaned out if we're going to be of any use, like cleaning the nets before the fishermen. So that's a good point I think is made. Another why is, why did Peter ask Jesus for a reason? Why should I put down the nets? Why should I go out to the deep? We've done this all night long. And why didn't Jesus even offer a reason? It's not like Jesus said, hey man, I just saw boatload of fish right over here. You know, put down your nets over there. No, he didn't. He just told him, do it. And Peter obliged. This is what faith looks like, being put into action. It doesn't demand reasons. It doesn't say, why God? Why do I have to do this? Can't we do it some other way? You know, ordinarily we want a reason for just about everything that we do before we will act in life. We want our boss to give us a reason. We want, I don't know, it's, you name it. It's like we always have to know why. Isn't that the first thing we learn when we're like 2 years old? You know, eat your peas. Why? You know, it's like we're, and we never outgrow that. But maybe if you don't like peas, that's reasonable. But when God is the one telling you to do, then it's not reasonable, you know, to ask God why. We are not entitled to question the Almighty. Peter, you know, in this situation, sitting there tired after a nice word, but hearing this amazing teaching from Jesus. And Jesus had said things that probably no man had ever said before. This was a description that was sometimes used. As far as Peter was concerned, after hearing these words, after seeing for himself everything confirmed about this man, Jesus, that was enough. That was reason enough. He was a man of God, and that was good enough. Once again, faith in action. We don't need answers for everything. We don't need to know why of everything. We need to know who it is that's speaking to us, and that should be enough. Peter obeyed, and he hauled in fish to fill several boats. And afterwards, we know that Peter, once they got to shore, he fell on his face before Jesus and said, depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord. Why did he say that? You know, it is reminiscent of Job, the afflicted and suffering one, who, if you've ever read the book of Job, first of all, congratulations. It's not unlike trying to read Moby Dick. It's just a long book, but a good one. And Job, pretty much throughout the book, spends his time protesting his innocence, protesting his righteousness before God, saying, I have done nothing to deserve this. And all the while questioning God's motives, right up until the point of when he actually sees God, when God grants him a vision, makes an appearance to him. And at that point, Job slaps his hand over his mouth and repents greatly. I am nothing but dust and ashes, he says before God. Job suddenly became aware of the greatness of the Creator and his own insignificance by comparison. Well, so that's what's going on here with Peter. Peter's not telling Jesus, get lost, scram, take a powder, receive. But instead, he's saying, in effect, I see you. And now I hate myself in comparison. A true vision of God is not about self-esteem. It doesn't inflate the ego or make one feel as if they've attained some kind of high spirituality. You know, you see all the time books by people, I have this vision and now read my book. I will teach you, oh little ones, you know, ridiculous. It's quite the opposite. A true vision of God is terrifying and humbling, and puts a person on their knees. Now one sees and will no longer question God. Now we will no longer ask why or demand reasonable explanations for God's actions or our need for obedience. Now we no longer think more highly of ourselves, our wisdom, our opinions, than we as mere creatures ought. Now we fall silent and obey God in faith and in love. It is at this point that we become true followers of Jesus Christ. When God is God and we are not, and we begin to follow Him, simply because he tells us and he speaks. When we are not mindful enough of God, we become extremely careless, even arrogant, in our attitudes and our behavior. So we must, I think, continually meditate upon the greatness of God. You spend more time thinking about your own problems, you don't have a Christian mindset. You need to be thinking about the greatness of God, the goodness of God, the majesty of God, and casting aside our fool opinions of ourselves in order to obey God in humility and to follow Christ in love. Glory to God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us. Keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy on us. We are poor and afflicted, and we are in need of thy mercy. We are poor and afflicted, and we are in need of thy mercy. We are poor and afflicted, and we are in need of thy mercy. We are poor and afflicted, and we are in need of thy mercy. We are poor and afflicted, and we are in need of thy mercy. We are poor and afflicted, and we are in need of thy mercy. We are poor and afflicted, and we are in need of thy mercy. We are poor and afflicted, and we are in need of thy mercy. We are poor and afflicted, and we are in need of thy mercy. We are poor and afflicted, and we are in need of thy mercy. We are poor and afflicted, and we are in need of thy mercy. We are poor and afflicted, and we are in need of thy mercy. We are poor and afflicted, and we are in need of thy mercy. We are poor and afflicted, and we are in need of thy mercy. We are poor and afflicted, and we are in need of thy mercy. We are poor and afflicted, and we are in need of thy mercy. We are poor and afflicted, and we are in need
now and ever, and unto ages of ages. For our Father and Metropolitan Joseph and all our brotherhood in Christ, the Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Servants of God, especially for the Archpriest Quainan Purielin, for the newborn Matilda Adele Catherine, and her parents Stephanie and Granite, for Ruth Augustine Gray, Jessica Nicola, Chris Michelle, Mark Autumn, Kelsey Michelle, Mary Christina, Lauren Claire, Stacy and Maggie, that they have mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon, and remission of their sins. The Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the Orthodox servants of God departed this life, and especially for Christopher and Alexander, the Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Ask of the Lord.
pardon and remission of our sins and transgressions, all things good and profitable for our souls, and for peace in the world, let us ask of the Lord.
And his soul.
That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, for a Christian ending to our life, painless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the awesome judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Lord. Calling to remembrance our all holy Immaculate, whose blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. Love one another, that with one accord we may confess.
Inconceivable, invisible, incomprehensible, ever existing and eternally the same, now in thy only begotten Son, and thy Holy Spirit. Thou bless you, just bring us from non-existence into being. And when we have fallen away, just raise us up again. And dost not cease to do all things until thou hast brought us back to heaven and hast endowed us with thy kingdom which is to come. For all these things we give thanks unto thee and to thy only begotten Son and thy Holy Spirit, for all things of which we know and of which we know not, and for all the benefits bestowed upon us, both manifest and unseen. And we give thanks unto thee also for this ministry which thou dost vouchsafe to receive in our hands. Even though this can be sung to thousands of archangels and 10,000s of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, 6 winged many eyed sword of love borne on their pinions, singing the triumphal hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and saying,
thank you.
our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with you all.
Thank you.
save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
Blessed be the name of the Lord, from this time forth and forever.
ages of ages. Of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and all laudable apostles, of our father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of Saint Barnabas, patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, who came in heaven, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious proto-martyr Thecla, equal to the apostles, the venerable Silvan of Athos, the new martyr Ahmed, the venerable Nicander of Skull, and all saints of Alaska, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us, for as much as he is good and loves us, mankind. Prayers of our Holy Father, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.